Russian Justice Ministry has sent letters to two major US-funded media outlets and their subsidiaries too, notifying them that they may soon be designated as foreign agents. The move comes in response to RT being forced to register as a foreign agent in America. RT's Samira Khan has the details.
Well, the new legislation targets U.S.-funded outlets, including Voice of America, Radio Free Europe, and its other regional branches. This comes only a few days after RT America was forced to register as a foreign agent or have all of their assets frozen. Russian RT have been regular topics of discussion at various hearings in the U.S., discussing alleged Russian interference in the 2016 election. But until this very day, there has been no evidence to substantiate any of these claims. Under the Foreign Agents Registration Act, RT America will now have to disclose its finances, provide regular reporting on its activities, all within 48 hours. They'll also have to add a disclaimer on all of its work. The ministry's latest decision is a mere response to Washington's recent crackdown on RT, and its measures are similar to those required under FARA, including disclosing finances and providing evidence of editorial independence. As news of Russia's response went global, Amnesty International was quick to react and released a statement on the issue, saying that the legislation strikes a serious blow to what was already a fairly desperate situation for press freedom in Russia. But the organization's concern wasn't extended to RT America when they were initially targeted by Washington. We reached out to several press freedom watchdogs for comment, and they didn't appear to be so outraged, to say the very least. Their responses ranged from not being informed on the topic to only being able to comment on non-domestic issues. But this is the first time that Russia has specified a list of companies that could possibly be designated as foreign agents, but we're actually still waiting for the official announcement.
Well, we discussed Russia's reaction with RT host Afshin Ratansi and also British journalist Neil Clark.
When we heard last week that RT had until the following Monday to register as a foreign agent in America, there was silence from groups like Amnesty and other groups that are supposed to be defending free speech and free media. And yet, when Russia very reasonably announces reciprocal measures in response to these measures from the US, then all of a sudden, these so-called impartial Western pro-human rights organizations come out and say, this is outrageous, this is terrible, Russia is clamping down on free speech. So really, it's very, very transparent. You only have to look at what's happened the last 5 days to see the rank hypocrisy.
Well, US authorities wanted a media war, and Russia's giving it right back to them. I presume that if Radio Free Europe and Voice of America are on this Russian list, one can only presume that the Russian Kremlin and the Russian government, they understand that these were well known as propaganda outlets well before this decision. So obviously it is tit for tat.